Thank you so much for having me, Amana. Thank you so much. Isn't this an incredible event, you guys? Let's give everybody at Amana a hand real quick. So I asked him to keep the lights on for a little bit, A, because if I see you sleeping, I'm coming off the stage. I'm probably coming off the stage either way. I'm Jennifer Bagley. I'm the CEO of CI Web Group, which is one of your guys' preferred vendors for digital marketing strategies. You guys here to learn some technical aspects of the business, but also, are you interested in learning how to make money? More leads, yes? Fantastic. It doesn't matter what industry you're in. Typically, we have a challenge with the trade industry. I think we're going to have a presentation here soon. Got it. So, doesn't matter what industry you're in. Typically, we learn technical aspects about a business, yes? But one thing that we miss out on, how do we generate new customers? Anybody have a challenge with that? Anybody want more new customers? Yes, raise your hands. This is going to be interactive. I saw you in the last presentation. It's not going to work. Okay? All right, fantastic. We're going to talk today about how to leverage technology to convert time to cash. How to leverage technology to convert time to cash. Do we have any technology lovers in the room? I have one, two, five, maybe 12. Haters. Love haters. Who's not paying attention? All right, fantastic. So, this is what we're going to talk about today, high leverage activities. So if you have a pen and paper, you're going to want to take notes. You're going to take this back. This is going to be highly valuable. Write down HLAs, high leverage activities. These are activities that are going to help you move towards your vision. So if your vision is to grow, expand, pick up another zip code, pick up another area, start doing more of a particular installation or product sale that you haven't done in the past, this is what we're going to do in order to be able to achieve those goals. But let me back up. Everything is about doing the right things in the right order at the right time. It's hard in a marketing position. You guys go to a conference or a speaking event, you listen to some twit, teach you how to tweet, and all of a sudden you think you need to be on Twitter. How many of you love Twitter? Okay, I'm with you. I have like 250,000 followers. Don't log on to Twitter. Haven't. Went to a conference, gave that same story. Next thing I know, I found out that I have all of these people and I have it set up to where I can auto-post. If I post to Facebook, it automatically posts to my Twitter account. Next thing I know, I had someone come up and say, you had people in the audience requesting quotes for products and services that you sold, and your competitor who spoke after you was answering them. Do I need to pay attention to Twitter? You tell me. Wait, say it again. Do I need to pay attention to Twitter? Yes. Okay. Do I want to? I can't even say tweet and have it feel professional. However, okay, so you guys, marketing, there's a lot to it, right? How many of you are second generation, third generation, you took the business over from your fathers, grandfathers? Yeah? Have things changed in marketing a little bit? Absolutely. Marketing is really boils, I love lights. Now I can see if you're paying attention, Javier. Okay, so, all right, fantastic. I love marketing, but really it boils down to one thing. All marketing is what I'm doing right now. What am I doing right now? Communicating. That's all it is. So as technology changes, all it is changing the way and the position in which we communicate. If I stop talking, do I stop selling? If you stop talking, do you stop selling?
Yes.
Guys, so all it is learning a new technology or a new device. How many of you have a teenager or know a teenager? So a year ago, what did they use to communicate? What social media network? Facebook. Do they use Facebook today? They think Facebook's for dead people. You know that? They literally do. Imagine having an entire body of people who you're trying to do business with decide they're going to use an entirely different set of communication in 30 days, and if you don't follow, you don't exist. Whew, that scares me. Okay, so if you don't have these, you guys, you have a piece of paper in front of you, you don't have to write these down. If you flip it over to the white side, one side's red, one side's white. At the very top is this list: strategy, content, websites, branding, video, mobile, social media, SEO, email marketing, CRM, local, and PPC. This is in the right order. So when you go to the conference or you watch the webinar or somebody tells you you need to be doing X, Y, and Z, you should be leveraging pay-per-click. If the things on the top left corner are not done yet, if they're not performing well, if they're not in position properly, we're going to skip the things in the lower right-hand corner. Okay, and I'll explain why. All right, when it comes to digital marketing, many times I'll ask audiences, why don't you do the things that are necessary in order for you to be able to accomplish your goals from a digital marketing standpoint? They say, I don't have, survey says, enough. I'm gonna do it one more time. They say they don't have, survey says.
Time,
absolutely. However, for you, how many of you are in sales? How many of you repeat the same thing over and over and over and over again when you're on the phone with clients or customer service? Yes? So it's not that we don't have enough time. It's technically that we're misappropriating our time by living in Groundhog's Day. Have you seen that movie?
Yes.
Yes? That's a bad day, right? That's a bad day. I don't want to wake up and do the same thing every single day. So it's not necessarily that we don't have enough time. Maybe that we're not digitizing the information necessary to work for us so we can go do something else. So if you find yourself doing something manual, redundant, repetitive, or inefficient, it might be time to pull back and digitize. I'll give you an example. At this event, I have this gentleman right here. Turn around, look back. If you're in this row, you should wave, smile. Turn your right side, good side. Okay, so I have this gentleman with me, Scott Smith, who runs our video production department. If I was to come to this event and I was to speak for an hour, or half hour, I think I have 30 minutes, if I was to speak for a half an hour and then leave and I don't have him, what do I have afterwards? A memory. Oh, that was good. I'm going to use that next one. Okay. You almost got a book for that. All right. However, if I digitize it and I record it and I post this video to YouTube, then what do I have?
A tool.
A tool. An asset. So you guys, simple interest versus compound interest, right? This would be simple interest, coming to an event or answering a sales question over and over and over again. Compound interest is that we record this video, upload it to YouTube. Next year, I have more what?
Followers.
More followers, more views. The year after that, I have more what?
Business.
More business. And the year after that, I have more what?
Money.
There, okay. All because of 30 minutes on this stage and digitizing that moment. So if you think about it in your business, if you are in Groundhog's Day answering the same question over and over and over again and you're not digitizing it, then you're not replicating yourself, therefore, you don't have any tools that are working for you. I don't have a sales team, don't have to have a sales team, because I have hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of thousands of me in a digital environment that work for me while I'm on the beach. Do you like the beach? All right. Strategy. We've got to have strategy and plan. Tell me this, are these your goals? One, increase lead generation. Say yes.
Yes.
Two, increase customer referrals.
Yes.
Do you guys want your clients to refer to you as my HVAC company or a HVAC company? My big deal. Javier. Javier comes up. I'm going to pick on you, okay? Can I tell a story real quick? Javier comes up to me. He says, you don't remember me like a half a decade ago. I helped you with your AC. I was like, well, shoot, I just got it replaced like 2 weeks ago. He's like, why didn't you call me? Why didn't you stay in touch? I'm just I'm sorry. That's hard. So starting to think or create a plan that says, I want to be known as my HVAC company. It's hard. It's not easy, but it will help with that. Increase upsells from existing customers. Yes? Increase customer retention. Yes? Is it easier to keep a current client than get a new one? Cost a heck of a lot less. Improve operations. Yes? All right, so write this down or just look on this red sheet of paper. Clarity, focus, and execution. Think about it this way. Without clarity, you cannot focus. Without focus, you cannot execute. If you don't execute, you cannot win. So clarity is knowing, what do I want? And what does it take me to get there? And saying no to everything else. So what does it take to get there? Those are your high leverage activities. How many of you have a website? Yes? All right, how many of you had that website built within the last year? Or rebuilt? Yes. All right, how many of you know what kind of website you have, what it was built in? WordPress, fantastic. I have a laser. Okay, anyone else? So let me give you some ideas, okay? Here's some different ways websites can be built. You have what I call the triple Fs. Anyone want to guess what the triple Fs are? The first one is friends, build it for you. The second one, any thoughts? Family, absolutely. And the third one is? Fools. I can hear you thinking. Okay, but it wasn't that word. It was a different. All right, friends, family, and fools. No, no, and no. Those all go on the do not call list. Very important. Your website is your asset. That's what you own. That is the only thing you own. Do you own Facebook? Do you own Twitter? Do you own YouTube? Not necessarily, and they change. You own or should own your website. It's also a permanent asset to your business, meaning when I add a page or a post on a website, the longer it's there, the more powerful it becomes, therefore the more performance I get out of it. If I add a Facebook message or a tweet, if I add that, how long does that last? Matter of seconds, and then it's in history land. So if you go to Facebook, you don't go through somebody's history, right? It only lasts for a matter of seconds. So should your website or blogging or adding content be more important than social media? Technically, yes, if you're prioritizing. All right, WordPress, absolutely. Also, you want to be careful of people who specialize and they only do one industry. What you need out of a web company is somebody who specializes in what? Websites, and their God is Google. Okay, Google is God in the website world. And I say that because everything that you have to meet, all of the requirements and standards, comes from Google, and it changes constantly. So you want them to be an expert at that. That's hard enough on its own. Having familiarity with your business, absolutely. Now, you guys, for your industry, every single website must have a series of pages that represent each product and each service and each brand that you represent. So how many of you have seen Bruce Almighty? Do you remember? Okay, perfect. Do you remember when he goes into that big warehouse and God says, I have this file drawer, and everything you've ever thought, everything you've ever done is inside this filing system? Yes? That's Google. So when you go type in a phrase, you notice at the top left-hand corner it says 10 out of or 1 out of, 200,000, 200 million, 100 million, 67,000, whatever that is, yes? That's a huge drawer, but it's only a drawer full of pieces of paper with one thought. So on each one of your websites, you can write this down, here's your structure. You're gonna have AC, and then underneath it, one page per variation. AC installation, AC maintenance, AC service, AC warranty, AC systems. Is that what people look for? It is. Now, if you have one that just says HVAC, but my air conditioner's broken, somebody goes to Google and they're searching just for air conditioning, they may not find your website because it just says HVAC. So, same thing. You call it furnace. You may have a consumer that calls it furnace or heater or heating. And then you have your variations, heater installation, heater service, heater warranty, heater maintenance, heater systems, or furnace, same thing. One page per thought. Make sense? Yes? How many of you have it set up like that? We have, okay. So we have a lot of work to do. All right? The worst thing you can do is have a page that says our services. So you have heating, air conditioning. What about indoor air quality? Same thing, indoor air quality tests. What about boilers, depending on where you're at? Boiler installation, boiler replacement, burners, and so forth. So that's first and foremost. What I'm doing is outlining what you need to do in what order. First is by product or by what people are searching for. Second is, remember when I asked you, do you answer the same questions over and over again? Yes? How many of you have a page that says FAQ on your website? Okay? FAQ or services is what's called a junk page, a junk drawer. Because Google's taking the phrase that says FAQ and putting it into a huge directory of FAQ pages. Does that help you? No, not at all. So what you want to do is inside WordPress, you have a category called FAQ. But each individual question is its own post. So the post says, oil to gas conversion. What's the benefit of oil to gas conversions, for example? Okay, that post is the individual question that an individual is searching for on Google. The title of that post is what gets shown to those people who are searching. Make sense? So pages first, posts second, and the posts are all of the most recent or frequent questions you get asked. What else do you guys get asked on a regular basis? Yes? No?
What areas do you serve?
Perfect. So that's very smart. On your site, for each particular city or county or zip code, you need to have one page for that location. You want to expand your service to a new location? You don't put a piece of paper inside that drawer. You don't get to go into that service area. Make sense? So for each area, you need to do the same thing. Let me show you a couple examples. Okay, residential cooling. So for this particular search, our client sits in position 1, 2, and 3. And then what we did is we used 3 different websites, our own sites, to knock off all their competitors out of position 4, 5, and 6. Beneficial? Because each one of those pages points back. So the goal would be to identify what phrases do you want to be found on the first page of Google for? How do you gain a first page, page 1, position 1 rank? Then how do you capture position 2, 3, and 4? And then how can you bump them out of the way? So now directory listings and social media accounts can help with that. So on your social media accounts, how many of you have Facebook fan pages? Twitter? Yes? You do? Do you use them? What is the definition of use? Okay, so let's look at social media real quick. There are 2 different kinds of social media strategies. The first one is the protector. Essentially, this means on your website, you need to have the ability to follow you on your social sites. Typically, it's going to be in the top right corner. You also need to have the ability to share. So if somebody has that question and they want to share it with their network, they can hit the button and share it. How many of you have follow? Top right corner? Hopefully. How many of you have a share button so they can share your content on their social networks? Handful. All right, commenting. If somebody is on your blog because they went to Google and they typed in the question, your blog post came up, do they have the ability to comment on that particular, do they have the ability to comment on that particular post, and when they comment, it auto-posts to their Facebook account versus using WordPress commenting? That plugin, by the way, if you're using WordPress, is called Facebook SEO commenting. You can write that down and install that. All right, next, auto-posting. There's a couple different ways to get content out to Facebook. The best way, obviously, is for you to post it. Secondly, you can set up a program called IFTTT. If you write down IFTTT, you can set it up that anytime you add content to your blog, it auto-posts to your social media account. Beneficial? Fantastic. All right, fan building. In a protector environment, think of it this way. So for your social media accounts, if you are out on the street, you're working, you're a networking event, you have other sales strategies where you're generating leads and opportunities, they're gonna go look at your website first, and they're gonna make a decision, are you professional? Are you trusted? And are you credible? and they're going to look at your site, then they're going to look at your social sites. The protector is going to make sure they have at least 1,500 fans so they don't look brand new or out of business. They're also going to make sure that they have content posting on a regular basis. The aggressor, totally different. This is somebody who wants to generate business on social media accounts regularly. They're going to put together an editorial calendar, a content schedule, maybe some promos or campaigns and so forth. How many of you feel like you're in the aggressor status? Okay, so that's cool. That's cool. We have to make sure from a protector status that we have everything that we need. And really, you guys, that's a matter of one and dones. Means you can put those things in place very, very quickly, get it out of the way, automate most of it so that you know you're not going to lose your most valuable asset, which is your referral sources. Make sense? All right. So simple. Professionally branded. I think they have 10,000 fans. They post content on a regular basis. Now, Anne and Joey, they've been working on Facebook for, what'd they say, 7 years? Called up. We've never got one piece of business off Facebook. All of a sudden, the first client they got, yippee, they were so excited. So it is a matter of getting comfortable, getting out of the protector stage and getting into someone who wants to aggressively generate new business, which means engaging your own network. All right, if this doesn't sound important, I want you to think about this. In 1,000 days, my 16-year-old, how many of you have a teenager? Yes? Are they on social counts? Okay, they probably have pretty big networks. You may or may not know about all of them. Exactly. Our kids are either going to be our employer, client, or competitor. I know our son, he's 16, has a database probably larger than most of this room combined at 16. The way they communicate, the way they persuade and influence, change people's mind, the way they do business, the way they do research, totally different than what we're used to. How many of you want to be in business in 1,000 days? How many of you want to kick their butt? Okay? It makes me a little bit nervous, it really does, because these guys are fast. They communicate different, they use technology much different. They're very mobile. But in 1,000 days, we're gonna have a new set of customers and a new set of clients and a new set of possible competitors. Is this a generational business? Yeah. Is it possible the next generation is gonna run and compete with you in your area? Absolutely. I would get this technology thing down as quickly as possible. And really, it's not that difficult. All right, mobile. How many of you have cell phones on you? Yes? See, typically there's more people with cell phones in a room than people without underwear, and usually it's the one that's giggling in the back. So, are you communicating mobile? Is that part of your business? So is your website mobile? How many of you have a responsive website or know what that is? Yeah, raise your hands, look around. All right, great. That means essentially your website resizes or reshapes itself when somebody pulls it up on a mobile device. Very important. Google really looks at websites and are they responsive? How many of you have a mobile app? Or we'd even consider it? Yes? Yes? Fantastic. Now, are you doing push notifications to remind people of service? It works well, doesn't it? Fantastic. So another great way. How many of you would love to get an email newsletter in your inbox? Look around. How many of you would rather watch a video than get an email newsletter? Okay, look around, raise your hands and look around so you can see. How many of you would rather watch a video than read a blog post? Raise your hands and look around. Okay, how many of you would rather read the headline than a full article? Raise your heads and look around. I said raise your heads. I want to see you do that. Okay, all right. The bottom line is, everybody likes to be communicated with differently. So think about this. In the last 12 months, how many of you have made a purchase because of, now you are not an existing customer, radio, television, newspaper, magazine, billboard, or cold call? How many of you have made a purchase from a new vendor, service provider, product, anything, in the last 12 months because of one of those mediums? Anyone? Yes? What'd you buy? A computer? From where? Now, what kind of medium did you see that in? Which one of those marketing or advertising?
A radio ad.
Fantastic. All right, you.
TV.
What'd you buy?
Bought one off of Best Buy.
Okay. You've never shopped at Best Buy before?
Yeah, well, no. That was the first time I purchased.
It was the first time. Okay, fantastic. Are these good results? If you go to school for marketing and advertising, guess what you learn to do? Exactly what I just covered. I can ask any audience, any room, anywhere, how do you buy? How do you research? It's less than 1% of any audience anywhere I've ever spoke that has made a purchase from any traditional marketing mediums. However, in your business, how many of you have invested in any of those to market your business? Raise your hands. Look around. Okay, it's that simple. I'm an operations girl. I want things that produce faster. Okay, everything I do is about accelerated results. So let's check this out. In the last 12 months, how many of you have made a purchase because you went online, did research, found a product or service, and you bought it off the internet? Look around. All right, how many of you have gotten a referral to a friend or family member or colleague or a service or a product, and because of a referral, you've made a purchase? Look around. How many of you Googled them first before you even contacted a referral? Raise your hand high and look around. Okay, this is my deal. I want the highest results with the least amount of effort. Bottom line is, consumers today are making their purchases two ways. A, via the internet, B, via referral. However, they're validating those referrals on the internet before they even make that phone call. How many of you have Googled yourself or your company recently? Yes? You on the first page? Okay, we need to. For our own names. So if I, tell me your name.
Mike Douglas.
If you installed my unit and I wanted to refer a friend, I say, you know what, you got to call Mike Douglas with so-and-so. Guess what my friend is going to do? They're going to Google what? They're going to Google Mike Douglas and that company name. So you want to make sure anybody that's customer-facing has their own individual page as well, so that if somebody's Googling, I can find you, I can see testimonials and endorsements and so forth. Make sense? So, very, very important. If I have a penny to spend, I know where I'm going to spend it because I know how people buy. I don't want in anybody's business to try and figure out how to market my business by looking at what are other people doing, because that's the worst way you can learn to market your business. You guys are in a unique position. On one hand, you have to absorb all of the technicalities because you need to be a technical or subject matter expert. On the other hand, you're dealing with a bunch of consumers who are not technical experts. So when it comes to marketing, you have to speak in their language. You have to figure out what's important to them. Saving time, knowing you care, not how much you know. Make sense? And your technology can help you do that. All right, you guys. So we have very little time here. I'm just going to cover one other thing. You guys have a couple ways to get into all this technology. I want to introduce you to, this is my father and this is my son, both on the same roller coaster ride. One chose to smile. Both felt the same, but one chose to smile through the process. When it comes to finding out your website is not designed to market well, or finding out your SEO program maybe you've been investing in for the last 10 years is not going to help you get there, and that's why you're not ranking, it's not a fun process. I'm going to say choose to smile through all of it and get through it quickly. Okay? Both people, same exact feeling, one chooses to smile. We have a handful of things that I think will help you. One, as a preferred digital marketing agent for Amana, we are giving everyone the opportunity to sign up for a complimentary strategy session. No sales pitch. I'm an educator. So if you want to go through your website, your social media accounts, figure out what works, what doesn't work, and at least have an idea of what you should concentrate on, this, on the back of the red sheet, is a list of all the things technically you should have in place if you are doing the basics. If you're doing the basics, and these are the things that we'll cover and figure out what works, what doesn't work, what can you eliminate, What can you focus on? Where are your high leverage activities to grow your business? We also have, so you guys, if you're interested, fill this out. If you're lazy, drop a business card in the pumpkin. We figured it was fitting because it's Halloween. In the pumpkin head over there. And also, anybody that drops a business card in there, we're giving away a free landing page design, free email newsletter design, a free video. So you guys, drop that in there. We'd be happy to help you out. Is this information helpful?
Yes.
You have some work to do?
Yes.
You want another book?
No.
All right, you guys, thank you so much for having me. I appreciate it, and we look forward to seeing you over here afterwards. Thank you.